Ever since I was a little kid, I was always under the understanding and belief that money was the devil. Essentially, it was instilled in me from a very young age that money was the be-all and end-all of everything in life. I was taught and brought up to believe that having money in your life was the only true way that you were ever going to be super happy. And essentially, if you had none, you had nothing. You was never going to find success. You were never going to find true life meaning happiness. This was absolutely cemented into my mindset as I was growing up. I certainly grew up with certain levels of anxiety in my life about money, and I would always have these kind of like really strong, overwhelming feelings of, am I making enough money? And, you know, what am I going to do in the future? Am I going to make enough money when I'm older to be able to, you know, live my life and be happy? It was always something that kind of overwhelmed me with negative feelings. I even realized recently, while studying the psychology of humans, that the reason I feared being fired so much through all the jobs I had in my entire time in my late teens to my early 20s was because of the underlying subconscious belief that money ruled everything. And if I didn't have that, I'd be disowned and life would become shit. So ultimately, money is something that I've always had a very negative relationship with. All of this came to head about 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago, when I came back from traveling around the world. Now, when we traveled, we hadn't actually saved that much money at all. We ended up working sort of cash in hand jobs, especially in Hawaii, Sydney, Melbourne, Singapore. We'd done a couple of cash in hand jobs, which really helped us along the way. I think it's safe to say that we just about got by on the monetary side of things. But hey, listen, what we did do was create some memories that we're never going to forget in our entire lifetime. And if there's one thing that you guys know this channel is all about, it is about creating moments and memories that we can tell stories to our grandkids that we know they're going to love. And for sure, 100%, when we went traveling around the world, it's the best thing I've ever done in my entire life. Like, I would advise anyone at any point in their life to at some point see the world. And then we came back and I was hit by this wall of anxiety, like, what the hell am I gonna do now? I'd spent all of my time just literally traveling around, just doing what I wanted to do every single day, you know, going to countries that were like super hot, super fun, doing just crazy stuff that was just so incredibly awesome. And then bang, click of a finger, it's all gone. It's done, it's finished, it's over. Also, at the same time that that was happening, I'd grown my Instagram account to 35,000 followers, and my girlfriend at the time had about the same. So we had like a 70, 75,000 follower reach. So we was actually working with a couple of small brands in different locations when we were traveling as well, like promoting their products on our Instagram. So we was making a little bit of cash that way. Obviously, when we come home, stop traveling, that all changed also. So it was like, what do I do now? What am I actually going to do? I'm going to feel like I'm going backwards. Am I really going to have to go back to that boring adult 9-to-5 job world that I know is just going to absolutely kill me inside? And at the same time that that was happening, I had my dad on my case, who was really just consistently hammering home that insight and that belief that I'd been brought up on, that I need to just get out and get a job. I need to get back to earning money. Just consistently every single day hammering it home, it is the most important thing. You need to get out and get that money. Thinking back to it now, it almost felt like it was a bit of a panic to just get me out the door as quick as possible to doing anything, even if I knew that that thing would just make me like die of unhappiness inside. Just get me out there, get me earning money, get me working, doing something somewhere. It just felt like I didn't really have time to do anything. When I come back, I had to go out and start earning money. Again, this was consistently instilling in me that money was the most important thing and that I couldn't have happiness or success or anything if I didn't have any. I felt like people were saying that I wouldn't be able to live my life properly or in any kind of happy state if I didn't have any. I felt like everyone would be disappointed in me and maybe disown me. And that subconscious trigger that I know that I have inside about money will be just that. It will be triggered if I ever find myself in a position where I have no money. So I paused for a moment. When I came back, I sat down and I'd done something I'd never done before. I took like 2 or 3 days of just doing nothing and just sat there and just thought, what matters the absolute most to me? Now, this was way back before I got into the realm of self-development, so I literally had no idea about anything and the psychology of how I was made up. I just thought I was just flying by on a whim and I had no idea that I could control things. But I asked myself two very important questions. The first one was, what do I like doing? What do I love? What am I passionate about? What do I actually care about? What am I absolutely loving with my life at this stage of my life? And the second question I asked myself was, well, what am I good at? What am I actually good at? What do people think that I'm good at? What do people perceive me as being good at? What do I perceive myself as being good at? And I came to the realization within the space of those couple of days that I could actually combine an answer to both of those. I had actually successfully grown my own Instagram account. I know I bang on about it all the time, from 0 to 35,000 followers in the space of a year and a half. So I thought to myself, well, hang on a minute. Why don't I reach out to my followers and say, you know, for a pretty cheap price, like $30, I'll grow your Instagram account every month for you. And lo and behold, in the space of a month from when I first started doing it, I was making more money than I'd ever made in any adult job ever. Now, obviously that is amazing, but it led to other things. And over time, I've found all these kind of like other little avenues and streams of places that I can go fishing for money online and essentially make an income from that. So sometimes I might be out filming something for another company or brand, or I might be out taking headshot photos for a company, or I might be making these YouTube videos, I might be, you know, doing something else online. Essentially what I'm saying is, over the last few years, all of those things have kind of congealed together and given me a nice, a small, but a nice little online income. Now, none of these things have made me a millionaire. I'm not financially free completely. I don't have an 8-bedroom mansion. I don't drive a sports car yet, and I will do one day. Law of attraction, sending that out there. But the truth of it is, the income that I do make from online world is enough to get me by. And that brings me on to the ultimate point of this video. Listen, there are things that you need to do. There are steps that you need to take, procedures that you need to put in place if you want to live an exceptional life on your terms. I can feel myself getting all like pumped up. This video is about to get super, super pumping, I promise. That is essentially what we all want. As human beings, that is the sole thing that we want. We want to live an exceptional life on our terms. We all just want a long, happy, healthy, wealthy, positive, safe, guarded, guided, protected life where we feel secure, where we can do all of the things we want to do. We all strive for greatness and we all want to achieve all the things that we've got in our head as our dreams, but there's certain things you have to do and have to understand to be able to do those things. You have to have your mindset in the right place when it comes to money, finances, where you get all of that from, and balance it with living a happy life, a positive life. And I can tell you this one thing, over the last couple of years, I've come to the ultimate realization that this theory that money is the be all and end all of everything and it is the meaning of life and all of that is complete and utter bullshit. Look, I understand that we need money to pay for rent, mortgages, bills, phone contracts, gym memberships, food, etc. And of course, doing fun things like going on vacations or playing golf, they all cost money. Essentially, yes, life does cost money. Whoa, wait, sorry. Even I've just realized how incredibly sad that is to say out loud that it costs money to stay alive. But let me tell you this, money does not make the world go round. It is not life or death. You and your life are much bigger than money. Money pays for my food and the roof over my head, which are hella important. But the things that bring me joy, like my family, my new niece, walks in solitude and nature, stillness, days out in the sun with the family and friends, playing guitar, playing football, going for a run, reading, learning, anything in that vein, are completely free. In fact, being completely honest with you, nothing that I pay for brings me as much joy as the things that I do for free. That was a beautiful quote that I actually made up for this video, and I mean it very much. Let's repeat the mantra. Nothing I can pay for will bring me as much joy as the things that I can do for free. I really do truly mean that. I guess really it comes down to a level of gratitude. Like, you know, I get to breathe. I get to see, smell, feel, hear. I have senses. And there's some people out there in the world that aren't blessed to have some of those things. But we want more, don't we? We want that exceptional life. And let me tell you this, the only time that you will be able to wake up whenever you want, work on the projects that you want to work on, focus on your passions and your hobbies and your dreams and your goals, the only time you're gonna be able to not have a boss, the only time you're gonna be able to boss your own life, the only time you're gonna be able to wear what you want, say what you want, do what you want, feel what you want, preach what you want, make channels like these kind of YouTubes whenever you want, the only way you're gonna ever be able to achieve any of those things is if you follow the very, very simple 5 steps in this video. Now, listen, if you put money at the top of the food chain, I promise you this, right? You are going to be working for the next 25 years miserably for somebody else. Putting money at the top of the tree sucks you back into the normality groove of life that a lot of people find themselves in. Now, let me tell you this very beautiful quote that I never ever forget. Working for somebody else will earn you a living. Working for yourself will earn you a fortune. And don't get that twisted, I'm not just talking about in a monetary term. If you swap the word money for sort of lifetime freedom, then I'm already a billionaire. So what are these super simple steps that you can take from today that will elevate your life to a level of euphoric happiness that you might not have experienced before? How can you finally get to that financially free position? How can you live an exceptional life on your terms? Step number one, shift your money mindset. From this moment on, come at life with a fresh new understanding that gratitude is key. Be thankful for not only what you already have, but be thankful for the things that you are so blessed in life to be able to do for free. Loving people costs nothing. Smiling costs nothing. Living in a beautiful state every single day costs nothing. Contributing your time and your energy to other people costs nothing. And listen, contributing your time and your energy to somebody else is the most fulfilling thing that you will ever do in return anyway. And it's free. Going for a run, walks in nature, reading, learning stuff, you know, reading books and studying them, all of that great stuff is all free. It is actually essentially free for us to live on Earth and experience the world's beauty. It costs nothing to do that. You just go outside. Challenge yourself, write yourself a little list of all the stuff that you could do for free and be grateful for that. Step number two, find your ground zero. So go away, grab yourself a pen and a notepad and write down all of your absolute essentials. This is essentially finding out what your very bottom line amount of money is that you can earn. This will be things like all your residual payments, like your rent, your mortgage, your utilities, your phone bill, your gym membership, stuff that comes out of your account pretty much every single month, your essential stuff you need to stay alive and have for living. So write them all out, tally all of those numbers up, and this will give you one solid number, and that number is your bottom level red line. Now you want to add a couple of figures to that. You want to move up to the not necessarily essentials, kind of necessities, stuff like toiletries, food shops, maybe you enjoy one trip to the cinema a month or something like that, but the things that you kind of have to buy to stay alive, I mean, you have to buy food to stay alive, but you know what I'm saying? All of those kind of peripheral things that are above mortgage, rent, all of that kind of stuff. This will give you a new figure. This figure will obviously be a little bit smaller than the first one. Combine them together and you will have in front of you your ground zero figure. This is the absolute bottom standard, the lowest standard. This is the very, very minimum amount that you can earn in life. Step number three, welcome to 2020. We no longer live in 1995. We don't live in a period of time where you have to work in an office or a warehouse. From probably 2013 onwards, and certainly from 2016-17 onwards, there has never been a better time for you to make a business online. Now, why is this important? Why do I believe that everyone should have this same mentality and same mindset to earning money? Well, first off, obviously, if you have your own business and it's 100% online, then your office is the entire globe. You have complete location freedom. You could literally on a Monday morning wake up, pick your laptop up, put it in your backpack, and catch a flight to Greece and go work in a little cafe in Greece for the weekend if you wanted to. Maybe you could jump in the car and drive up to the mountain range that's near your house and work in a little cute log cabin with the rain pouring down outside. And then during the days, you could go out on big hikes, like enjoy your life, but working in really cool different locations. I'm not gonna lie, after being pretty hooked on watching season two of You, I've really, this last week, been considering packing my whole bag up and going to Los Angeles for 3 months, just to sit in cafes and work there and experience life being in Los Angeles. Unfortunately, I do actually have quite a few film projects that are going on in the city that I live in right now, so maybe next year, maybe America, I'll see you next year. The second thing that's great about that is that you have complete time freedom as well. Now, I've been a creative individual that's been working in the freelance world online for the last 3.5 years, almost 4 years now. And I can tell you, I've never worked 9 to 5 in a structured day like that before. Like, sometimes I'll wake up in the morning, pick my laptop up at 6 a.m. and I'll be like super busy till like 9. Then I'll go to the gym. Then I'll go for a run. Then I might go and play golf in the afternoon, but I'll always come back and I kind of intuitively pick my laptop up and do work when, you know, it seems right to be doing work. Essentially, I don't really control the workload, how that comes into me, but when it does come in, obviously I just work hard on the projects that I'm working on, if that makes sense. You know, there's been times where, like I said, I've worked from like 6 a.m. till like 10 a.m. in the morning, then I've had nothing to do all day, so I've just chilled and lived my life. But then I'll get like an influx of emails at like 9 p.m. and I'll be working till midnight. So it's kind of like all over the place, and I'm sure there's a lot of other sort of freelancers out there that might be watching this video that will 100% agree with me that is the way that things are. Essentially, you don't have a boss anymore. You are your own boss, so you just completely manage all of your own time. Now, this step number 3 is actually super vital. Understanding that you no longer have to do what you are currently doing that doesn't feel right to you will completely change your whole outlook on work-life balance. And the thing is, I know there's people out there that might be thinking to themselves, but I'm different to you, Stuart, or I'm different to those people. And I know there's some people that are doing it. Oh, I wonder how they got to do it. Listen to me when I say this, right? Millions of people are making thousands and thousands. I'll say that again. Millions of people around the world are making thousands and thousands of dollars every single month, purely 100% online, working on their passions. And do you know what? I'm going to go as far as saying there are probably hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people who are making millions a month online, working on their passions. So you absolutely can do it. You have to have the understanding and the belief in yourself that you absolutely can do it. Listen, I'm like the worst role model in the world in some respects, because I got fired from every adult job I ever had in my life for just, you know, being the class clown, always trying to make people laugh. When I was at school, I got kicked out of the last year of school because, again, all I wanted to do is just make people laugh. I just literally didn't care about doing any of the work. And I'm sure if I can go from being that kind of person to somebody that just decides one day, I'm gonna help people grow their Instagram accounts, and within the space of a month, I'm making $3,000 a month, then anyone can do it. You guys can actually do it. So step 3 is essentially just understand that times have changed, things have changed. A lot of stuff has come online, and you can go and grow your own business online too. And the most important thing is, there has never been a better time to do this. Step number 4, what, how, and why? Finding what you will do is simple, in my opinion. Just ask yourself those 2 very simple questions. What do I like doing? What am I passionate about? What do I care about? And the second question, what am I actually good at? Once you find the answer to both of those, simply just find a way and get a strategic plan for how you're gonna combine those answers together. Because ultimately, if you can find something that you actually care about with something that you're good at, that's a recipe for success right there. You will never actually feel like you are working a day job. You will just be feeling like you're earning money for living your passions. And And if you're not good at something that you are super passionate about and you care about a lot, then get good at it. Get out there, study it, learn it, buy courses on it. There are so many blueprints for being good at something. All you have to do is just go online. Most of them are free, but you can also go out and go one step further and buy courses and stuff, and you can become an expert. You can become the go-to guru in that thing. I would also like to add in here that you should never do something that you are good at but not passionate about, because you can always learn to be good at something that you actually care about, but what's the point in doing something that you don't love? The population of the world is rife with, say for example, complaints handlers, that I'm sure they're very good at their job and very good at handling complaints because they've been trained to, but that doesn't mean that they don't want to put a gun to their head every day that they walk through the office doors. So find what makes you truly happy and combine that with something that you are actually good at. Hone your skills in it, become an expert in it, constantly be learning more about it, immerse yourself in that world. And once you've done that, you'll be able to build an online brand around that thing and people will come to it. Often our why is a great place to start when we're thinking of these ideas of what we're gonna do. You know, what am I good at? What do I care about and I'm passionate about? And then the why of why I wanna be successful. Unfortunately, when it comes to the how you will do this, I can't really be of that much help because your business model might be completely different to what mine is. However, I would say that the how is not necessarily a hard thing. You just need to write out a business plan. You need to write out your goals for it. You need to have a strategy in place, and then you need to implement hard attacks on those strategies so you can actually be successful in it. So I'll give you an example, as I always do in my videos. So my love and my passion and something I care about so much is filmmaking. I also happen to think that I'm pretty darn good at filmmaking. I've been traveling around the world for the last couple of years, making videos for people as big as, you know, Grammy nominated artists in sold out arena tours. So like, I feel like I'm good. And you guys tell me I'm good. I'm good, right? Please comment below and tell me that I'm really good at making videos. I also realized like 7 months ago now, 7, 8 months ago, however long ago it was, that there's a market out there for people that are looking for self-development, people that are looking for ways to better their lives. So my overall target and my goal and my dream is to have a successful YouTube channel, this one, where people can come to it and they can learn stuff, but also I can earn my income. My full income, entire income that I make solely from this YouTube channel. I would absolutely love to just be able to travel around the world, go and stay in different places for different amounts of time, just take my mic, my camera, maybe not my entire light rigging system, but just take all of my camera, my mic and stuff, and sit there and just make quality videos that give back and contribute to people. I just want to spend my days sitting there reading books, studying stuff, implementing stuff into my life, having life-changing stuff happen to me, and then delivering that back to you in hopefully a highly cinematic vision, and it actually contributing and helping you out. I'm not gonna blow my own trumpet too much, but since I started this channel 8 months ago, I honestly, hand on heart, would say that I've probably received close to 500 messages from people, whether that be DMs, emails, comments, whatever, saying that my YouTube channel is literally adding value to their life. And that is the most amazing thing, right? Of course, it is the most amazing, most fulfilling thing. But if I can eventually get a fee for that, not from you guys, unless you wanna contribute to my Patreon, top link in the bio below, I essentially wanna make that money from AdSense and sponsorships and stuff here on this YouTube channel. So how I will get there is by literally just being as authentic as possible and delivering free contribution and valuable advice as often as I can on this channel. And eventually, I will get big enough that I'll be able to charge a fee for it. You see, my business model only works if I stay consistently authentic. People are only going to magnet to me if I'm actually putting out, you know, valuable information. So again, sending that message out, law of attraction, out there into the universe, I hope and I desire that one day I make enough money from sponsorships and AdSense on this YouTube channel that I can be completely financially free. And that is my plan. And finally, step number 5. Action. This entire video is completely wasted if you don't do the number one thing in all of this. Take massive action. The biggest disappointment of life is those who spend time and money on gaining valuable information from books, videos, seminars, and doing nothing with the knowledge. The late great Bruce Lee said, "Knowing is not enough, we must apply. Willing is not enough, we must do." So put action to this idea, because I can promise you, if you can find something that you are passionate about and you become great at it, immerse yourself in it, study it, become a boss in it, you will have a business that is 100% online, and over time people will come. People will want to know what all the noise is about, and they will come to your door to see. That's when you can charge a fee for it. There's no such thing as overnight success. There is only massive, massive strategic action. So once you've hit all of these steps in this book, you will now have, first off, a baseline figure, your ground zero figure of what you need to earn. You will have some kind of idea of what you want to do. Then you'll have like a plan and a strategy and all the goals for it, for what you're actually going to do to get there. Then it's just a case of focusing on it, staying determined, staying like hungry, desiring to own your own business and be completely online, whether it is making a YouTube channel or your own film business or doing something completely different, just whatever you're passionate about, care about, and you're good at, combining those together, find your baseline figure and get to it. And I can promise you, if you stick at it, I absolutely promise you, if you stick at doing this, you will eventually start earning money, and this will give you lots of motivation to carry on doing it, and eventually you will break through that bottom line ground zero figure. Then as soon as you break through that threshold, you get through that ground zero figure and you start earning a little bit more than that, boom, you are free. Once you get through that barrier, you get through that first threshold that you've set yourself, it's like the whole world just falls off of your shoulders, because you suddenly just come into a new realm. You live in a new place completely. It's like you don't just quit your job, you also quit all of the old beliefs and limiting beliefs that you had about yourself and about your life. Like everything just falls away. It's like all the shit of life just crumbles off of you. When you get to that stage, you can start to find new avenues that you can start earning money from and go fishing in different areas and trial and error different things. And obviously you can start to build that, you know, that lower threshold number. You can build that higher and higher. You might put more things on there that you want to buy or do. And then this way you can start getting into the world of saving some of that money and ways that you can earn more of that money. But it's at that point that, most importantly, you will be able to start embracing living an exceptional life on your own terms, because you will essentially be working on your passions and doing what you love, and you will probably be doing something that's absolutely great and super fun, but you will be delivering a service to people that actually helps them. You will actually be serving people, serving others, which is the most fulfilling thing you can do anyway, but you'll be contributing, whether it's your time, your effort, whatever it is, to other people. You will be giving to people. You will be actually doing something that's meaningful. And trust me, when you get to that kind of stage where you're giving to people and contributing to people and you're doing stuff and helping them, but at the same time you're earning your money for that, like, that feeling is the best feeling on earth. It's the most secure feeling that you'll ever feel. And that's it, man. You're online. You can now go anywhere in the world that you want to go, and you can do anything that you want to do whenever you want to do it. You're completely free. This is the new age of life. In fact, in Timothy Ferris's book, The 4-Hour Workweek, he calls this the new rich. So I hope this video inspired you and hopefully lit a fire up underneath you as well. I challenge you right now to give yourself 3 to 6 months to go all in on this. Even if it's just a side hustle on the side of your school, your college, your work, whatever it is, I challenge you, right, to really sit down, maybe re-watch this video, write down everything that you're going to do with it, and go full hog, go like all in on this for the next 3 to 6 months, and then come back to me on this video at the end of the 3 to 6 months and just let me know what happened with you. I wish you all of the success in the world on this new journey that you're about to embark on, hopefully. If you enjoyed this video, if you found, you know, some of the tips and stuff valuable, please do consider subscribing if you aren't already, and smash the like button for me, because that's fun doing that. Don't think you're going to be able to see that from there because the brightness is too bright on here, but we've just hit 3,500 hours watch time, so we are literally like maybe 2 weeks away from being able to monetize this channel, which is just mind-blowing in the space of 7 to 8 months. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next Wednesday. Peace.